Hello everyone, and welcome back to my vlog. So before we start, let's put some color into this frame, shall we? I'm just using all the cheap painting stuff. Got them since I got here in Melbourne, and most of them has been harassed by my neighbor's kids. A little disclaimer, just to set your expectation at the right bar. So I'm not really a painter, if you may say, but I love to paint and I love to learn how to improve myself in painting. So this is me trying to do and improve while in lockdown. So I was hoping you'll have a little bit of idea of who we are gonna paint today with the intro that I made, but I guess it doesn't look like her. But guess what? It's Anne Frank. Just downloading her photo and let's start. Put your head on my shoulder. So why Anne Frank? Well, it's because during the second lockdown here in Melbourne, I've been watching a documentary film about Anne Frank, and it really gave me this inspiration. And I've realized a lot of things about myself, about my life, about the things that I want to do in my life. And my God, if you don't know Anne Frank, you should totally Google her or watch her documentary movie, because she is just, in today's layman's term, savage, classy, bougie, ratchet. And a few weeks ago, me and my girlfriends were discussing about godly passion, and somehow I have this realization, and it kind of connected with Anne Frank, and it inspired me to push on my passions, on the things that I love, and not wasting a single minute, because life is short and it's YOLO, man. And I want to share this to you, to everyone who accidentally clicks on my YouTube account, that whoever you are, wherever you are, or whatever situation you are in, nothing can stop God's will, not even death himself. Just like this girl Anne Frank, she wrote in her diary she wants to be of service of humanity, and that is something that she desired in the bottom of her heart, and I believe that God planted that desire in her heart. And even after her death and after all these years, she has kept inspiring hundreds and thousands of people throughout the world. We might not know it today, but there is a purpose for those godly desires and passions in your heart. But one thing that I am sure of is that those passions are not for you, but those are for other people. Getting the fame, getting the money, getting all those achievements are the result of following God's will for your life. And I know you may have heard this a lot of times, but in Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare, not for evil, and to give you future and a hope." Because just like what I've read in the book, the world desperately needs your enthusiasm, and just as importantly, you need the experience of sharing it. Just imagine a world without passionate people. Or maybe there are passionate people, but they didn't share it to the world. What would the world look like? I mean, what would life look like? Say, for example, Anne Frank. All she did was write passionately in her diary. She wrote everything about her emotion, about her feelings, being trapped in an attic with her family and a bunch of strangers. But more importantly, how she looks at life despite the annihilation of the entire Jewish population. To linger till down there. Just and check this out. Even though she was born 1929 and died on 1945, she became an inspiration to a group of young gangsters in America. In 1994, it started in an English class by an English teacher, Erin Gruwell. Over 150 students changed the course of their lives through writing. Based on this story, a movie was made entitled Freedom Writers, and I recommend you to watch it. A lot of lost people have changed their lives because of some few people who've done things passionately. Therefore, go and do what you have to do, because God is just right behind you. And if you don't, you're only delaying His good plants, and you're preventing other people from accepting the blessings and accepting the good things from you. Nobody may be watching my vlogs as of the moment, but I don't care, because God gave me this desire to do my vlogs, and I'm using this platform to show to everyone how God has been so good in my life.
And I'm gonna use the color orange for her background. Why orange of all the colors in the world? Because she found refuge in the Netherlands, in Amsterdam, where she and her family was hiding. My Anne Frank looks weird, but well, did my best. I hope Anne Frank will be proud of me and she will not visit me in my dreams and scare
me to death.
What the heck?
So that's it with our painting sesh today, and I hope you learned something. I'll see you again on my next video. Bye-bye.